Welcome, Ramley. How are my Rams superfans doing today? Today, we are going to recap the Rams versus the Arizona Cardinals. Let's get right into it. Now, the Rams lost to the Arizona Cardinals 37-20, and the game was a lot worse than the score indicated. First and foremost, I want to say sorry and give a huge apology to all the butthurt Arizona Cardinals fans that threw a riot in my comments when I said the Rams were gonna win by 14 points. You could tell you guys are not used to winning games. Just because I said I believe the Rams are one of the best teams in the NFL and the Cardinals aren't, doesn't mean that I should have 100 people throwing fits and crying in the comments. But I did appreciate the conversation and I was wrong, so I will give it to you guys. You guys are the better team. At least you were on Sunday. Luckily, we do see you guys again December 13th, and I cannot wait. I truly believe one of the reasons why we lost this game is because we just didn't play clean football. Through three games this year, the Rams played pretty much mistake-free ball. We had one turnover and only three penalties in three games. This Sunday against the Arizona Cardinals, we finished with five penalties and two turnovers, and Arizona did a phenomenal job of capitalizing off both turnovers, turning both turnovers into 14 points. But let's talk about the Rams offense. Now the Rams totaled 9 possessions, only scoring on 4 of those possessions, 2 touchdowns and 2 field goals. And one touchdown came at the end of the game when the game was already over. Now let's talk the Rams offense, and let's start by talking about the quarterback. Now Matthew Stafford is human. For the first time this year, Stafford did not play like an MVP candidate. And honestly, I think it was more Stafford than it was the Cardinals defense. He missed several throws. He finished a horrid 26 for 41 for 280 yards, 2 touchdowns, and an interception. And some of those stats were padded at the end of the game when the game was already out of reach. Now, I've given Stafford all the credit in the world through 3 weeks, so it's only right he takes the majority of the blame here as well. He was just simply off target all game. And guys, he has to stop trying to force the ball to Cooper Kupp. All season long, we wondered why Robert Woods isn't more involved in his offense. But we all kind of let it go because the offense was rolling without him. And on Sunday, Stafford locked in on Cooper Kupp and forced 13 targets his way. Robert Woods only had 3 targets before the final drive of the game. Honestly, guys, before this season started, I was always the one to say Robert Woods was our best wide receiver. I always thought it was really close, but I always gave the edge to Robert Woods. I honestly just thought he was always a little better than Cooper Kupp. Now, obviously, this season starts and Cooper Kupp kind of just blows everybody out of the water, which is great. But the talent level is not that far off to where Robert Woods should just be an afterthought in this offense. You look at all dynamic offenses in the history of the NFL and you have to spread the ball around. I mean, think about it. Isaac Bruce and Torrey Holt. Travis Kelce and Tyreek Hill, Marvin Harrison, Reggie Wayne, Demaryius Thomas, Emmanuel Sanders, the list goes on. In order for this offense to really take off, we had to spread the ball around. And frankly, it was just weird to see Stafford force the ball to Cooper Kupp, whether he was open or not. It was times he was doubled and triple teamed, and yet Stafford is still throwing his way. And then the times where Cooper Kupp was open, Stafford just missed the mark. It was just not a good sight. It was just not a good outing for Matthew Stafford this week. I'm really curious to find out what you guys think about Matthew Stafford's play. Please let me know in the comments. Now let's talk wide receivers. Now the wide receivers played pretty well. There were no drops that I remember. Van Jefferson had a great game. It was really good to see him progress in his offense. He finished with 6 catches for 90 yards and a touchdown. And like I said earlier, Woods has to get more involved. Stafford has to spread the ball around better and not give Cooper Kupp 31% of the targets, whether he's covered or not. Now let's talk to running backs. Sony Michel fumbled the ball early and it really hurt us. And Arizona did a wonderful job capitalizing on each turnover, scoring touchdowns on both turnovers the Rams had today. So hats off to them for that. Now Darrell Henderson looked great. This was his best game of the year by far. He finished with 89 yards on 6.4 yards per carry. It would have been a much better day for Henderson if the score didn't get out of hand. Shortly after halftime, rightfully so, the Rams abandoned the run once the game kind of got out of control. I seen a lot of people bashing Sean McVay on his play calling, saying that he should have stuck with the run. I mean, guys, the writing was on the wall. We had to save as much time as possible. I really don't fault McVay at all for getting away from the run and allowing Stafford to air it out. Stafford showed all season long that he was capable of getting in a shootout. That's what we have Stafford for. When we need to get in a shootout, let's shoot it out. I don't like the idea of being down halfway in the third quarter by 14 or 17 points and let's still hand the ball off every play. I don't blame Sean McVay for his play calling at all. If I was the coach, I would have did the same thing. But after his rib injury and him struggling the first few games of the season, it was really good to see Henderson step up and play well. Now let's talk the Rams offensive line. This was a perfect day for them big fellas up front. This was part of the reason Matthew Stafford's performance was so frustrating. The offensive line protected him tremendously. He had all the time in the world in the pocket. I don't remember him getting any pressure at all. He finished completely clean with no sacks. The offensive line also did a tremendous job in the running game, opening up holes for Darrell Henderson. On a day like today, where the bright spots were few and far between, that offensive line shined really bright. They completely had their way with Jones and Watt up front. And really quick, guys, before we get into the defense, if you could just like this video, drop a comment, subscribe, and also follow me over on Twitter and Instagram, I'd really appreciate it. Now let's talk the defensive possessions. Now the Rams allowed 7 scoring possessions out of 9, allowing 4 touchdowns and 3 field goals. This was just downright embarrassing. Now the front 7. They played absolutely horrible today, giving up 216 yards on the ground. Now I know these numbers can always be a little inflated when you play a mobile quarterback as good as Kyler Murray. Murray finished with 39 yards on the ground, and Chase Edmonds ripped off a 55-yard run in garbage time on the last drive of the game when the game was already over. So if we take away the 39 yards from Kyler Murray and that 54-yard run from Chase Edmonds at the end of the game, which I know we really can't take that away from the Cardinals, but if we do, the Rams front 7 still played like shit. They would have still given up 123 yards on the ground, refusing to stop anything in the red zone and doing a horrible job of getting off the field on third down. Now let's talk to Rams secondary. I really want to take a moment here to give out some flowers. Kyler Murray was amazing. He completed 75% of his passes and had 2 touchdowns. He was super accurate and made great decisions all game. Kyler Murray played how I thought Matthew Stafford would play. He did whatever he wanted to the Rams secondary. Short, intermediate, deep, it didn't matter. Kyler Murray is not only a legit star in this league, but after 4 weeks, he's probably the front runner for the NFL MVP award. And I'm telling you guys now, if he didn't play for the Arizona Cardinals, I would probably be a big fan of his. Now the Rams secondary is much better than this. I don't think this has caused a panic just yet, but something has to change. David Long Jr. seemed to be heavily targeted all game long, and Darius Williams didn't play much better either. Now, I don't really know what the solution is to all of this. Maybe get rookie cornerback Robert Rochelle a little more playing time? I don't know. Now, let's talk special teams. Now, Matt Gay is no longer perfect. He missed a 46-yard field goal in the middle of the third quarter that would have brought the Rams within 11 points. Now, after missing, you kind of had a sense that the game was officially over. And if you didn't believe that yet, the Cardinals got the ball back, marched right down the field, and scored another touchdown, really putting the game out of reach at that point. Now, I'm not going to kill Matt Gay for missing a field goal. You know it's going to happen. I didn't expect Matt Gay to be perfect all year. And honestly, the way we played, if he makes that field goal, we probably still lose the game anyway. Now, let's talk concerns. Now, I'm not panicking at all. Stafford played perfect through 3 games, and he had 1 bad game. And that's all this is, guys. It's just 1 bad game. But honestly, guys, I would be lying if I didn't tell you guys that Jared Goff popped in my head. Just the thought of a player playing like an MVP for a few weeks and then completely playing like dog shit after that, it was really reminiscent of Jared Goff over these last few seasons. Now, don't get it wrong, guys. I am not comparing him to Jared Goff. Not yet. I mean, he had 1 bad game. I don't expect this to be a habit. But like I said, it popped in my head. It was a thought. I think just Rams fans being scarred by having great quarterback play, followed by bad quarterback play, followed by good quarterback play, and bad quarterback play over the last 2 or 3 years, that thought did pop in my head. But like I said, I'm really not concerned just yet. I don't expect this to be long term. I don't expect Matthew Stafford to take us Rams on the same roller coaster ride that Jared Goff did. But I did think it was worth mentioning. Take it how you want it. His performance would have been a lot easier to accept if it was the Cardinals' great defense that caused all these issues for Stafford. But it really wasn't. It was Stafford himself just making poor decisions, after horrible throws, after horrible throws. I don't know if it's a good thing or a bad thing that we're on a short week and we play this Thursday. Gives him a chance to redeem himself quickly. Now, all phases of the defense look bad. The secondary, the linebackers, and that defensive line. Now, this Cardinals offense was a lot better than I anticipated, but I don't believe they're the 2003 Denver Broncos, and that's exactly how they looked like on Sunday against us. Now, we got the personnel on defense. Morris better put it together quick and make sure performances like this past Sunday do not happen again. Now, you know I like to end these videos out on a positive. The first one, it's just 1 game. That's all it was. It was 1 game. We're still 3-1. Guys, I was a Rams fan when we ain't made the playoffs for 12 years. We're 3-1. Breathe easy, relax. It's just one game. And second, sometimes it's good getting that loss out of the way. I wish it wasn't a home divisional game, but hey. On a week where every publication that covers football had the Rams ranked number one in the power rankings, sometimes it's good to get a slice of humble pie. Making sure we look in the mirror and we stay on our toes. Even though we had a great start to the season, we're far from the finished product, and we got a lot more work to do if we're gonna make a Super Bowl run. Please let me know in the comments what concerns you have, if any. Or was this just one game, and you're not worried at all? And before we get into the player of the game, if you guys could like this video, subscribe to the YouTube channel, and follow me on Instagram and Twitter, that would be great. Now let's give out the Rams Superfan Game Ball. Now it's a little weird giving out a game ball to the Rams when we played so bad. But in a game where we played so trash, there was a little bit of treasure among us. And I'm talking about the Rams offensive line. Now the game ball goes to Andrew Whitworth, David Edwards, Brian Allen, Austin Corbett, and Rob Havenstein. I couldn't just select one. As a unit, these guys played perfect. They all get an A+ from me. Virtually not allowing any pressure on Matthew Stafford, also opening up huge holes for Daryl Henderson to have the best game of his season. This was the one bright spot in this game. Now let's get into the NFC update. Obviously, the Arizona Cardinals sit alone atop the NFC West at 4-0. The Rams are currently second at 3-1. And after the Seattle Seahawks beat the 49ers, the Seahawks and the 49ers are both tied at 2-2. And the Rams are currently tied amongst four other teams for second place in the NFC. But guys, that's it for today. Be on the lookout for the Rams versus the Seattle Seahawks previews and predictions video coming soon. And you can check that video out and more by clicking on this right here.